The head of the Philippine Stock Exchange sees two huge initial public offerings early next year. PSE President and CEO Ramon Bunzon told ANC one of these is a closely watched $1 billion real estate investment trust of SM Prime Holdings. His bullish projection comes as he admits the current IPO market has been slow this year. Only three firms have so far gone public at the local bourse in 2024.
The market's, I guess, moving better than, you know, we expected. And we hope it will even be better if the rate cuts that everybody's anticipating really happens. This is not going to happen while interest rates are up, because rates really is are yield plays, no? But if the interest rates go down this year, I think the SM Prime REIT, which will be a big one, will happen first or second quarter next year. We've got, you know, a big, you know, gaming resort that's also planning to do an IPO. So we have a lot of big ticket IPOs to expect, you know, in the first half of next year.
Let's check on European markets first. They are up in afternoon trade, even as data showed inflation in the Eurozone unexpectedly edged up in July to 2.6%. The German DAX up about 0.5%, while the FTSE 100 is higher by 1.2, a day before the Bank of England comes out with its interest rate decision. As for Wall Street, futures also pointing to a positive open as investors brace for the Federal Reserve's policy decision, which comes out Wednesday afternoon in the U.S. or Thursday early morning in Manila. Contracts tied to the NASDAQ are up 1.5%. That's despite mixed results from tech giants Microsoft and NVIDIA overnight. Here's some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of HSBC, which announced a $3 billion share buyback as its current and incoming CEO assesses the lender's direction. HSBC shares rose 3.8%. Also in focus, shares of Just Eat Takeaway, which also bared a share buyback after reporting a more than 40% jump in its first half core profit. Shares of the Dutch food delivery company rallied 10.5%. We're also keeping a close watch on Starbucks, which reported mixed fiscal third quarter results. Its earnings matched, but revenue missed Wall Street estimates. Still, the stock managed to rise 3% in pre-market trading. Asian markets ended Wednesday trade on a positive note to close out the month of July. Chinese markets led gains, rising 2% after a third monthly contraction in factory activity raised hopes of more government stimulus to fuel the world's second biggest economy. But the main headline for the region, the Bank of Japan raising its interest rates for only a second time in 17 years. The BOJ also unveiled a detailed plan to slow its massive bond buying, taking another step towards phasing out a decade of huge stimulus. The Nikkei 225 climbed 1.5%, while the yen also rose against the U.S. dollar following the move.
If you look at the interest rate level or real interest rates, it's profoundly low, and we made a little adjustment. So I don't believe this will have a significant negative impact on the economy. We will keep raising rates and adjust the degree of monetary easing if the current economic price outlook will be realized.
Here at home, the local bourse snapped a two-day losing streak, with the main index locking in a 3% gain for the month.
We've reached 6,700, and that's really reflective of hopes. Hopes are up that interest rates are going to go down. They are going down already, and the BSP may deliver on the rate cut, first rate cut by August, either in August or September, depending on the inflation for July. I think the market is already starting to take profits on the expectation that the BSP is going to cut rates maybe ahead of the Fed, and that inflation may be still within the 2-4% band, and of course we would like to see inflation go down below 3.5%.
Some notable stock movements in the region. Samsung shares surged 3.5% as it reported a more than 15-fold rise in its second quarter operating profit and forecasts a strong AI-driven demand for chips in the second half of the year. Meanwhile, Toyota's shares slumped 1.5% after the Japanese government ordered the automaker to make drastic reforms following new violations in its vehicle certification procedures.